see if they can actually set up the vision first.
There was the huge swing it seems to be happening when teams don't really know where to go from that mid game. Top, bottom, go down. A little bit of a fight for mid, but somebody's caught out going for a buff or a dragon. And away the game goes. Let's see if it happens.
Brilliant soul target here. Off of the bat from Echo Fox. Looking for CLG to switch over to the roam play.
Jamil Rengar.
Preempting it.
LB, I mean, LB would still be a good bandier for Froggen.
I would not, yeah, exactly like we thought. CLG are not feeling good about the way the trade went down last time around. Rather play with the OPs off of the table here.
Yeah, because they already banned Camille when they were on blue side too, so looks like they're going to have to for this one. And first phase is out. Do they grab that Varus for keys, keep it safe? No, they get the Kha'Zix for Akkadian.
Yep, tier one jungler left up here, Kha'Zix on Akkadian. He will... I mean, he's looked good on a lot of other picks, so it's going to be interesting to see how the AD carry trades do come through, if they do value the Varus like most other teams do, way more than the Jhin. But the reason you're going to go for Kha'Zix first here is because the Jhin last time was on the ban table in the first round of bans, and you can't really answer with that. So Echo Fox and Keith, he should be fine just to play the Jhin. Varus will have, you know, that advantage during the lane phase, though. And CLG once again also going with the Shen, looking to get set up more of those cross map plays.
Malzahar was actually first banned by Echo Fox last game, phase one. Looks like they want that for Gate this time. We have seen Gate be one to kind of steal supports away from his opponents, but this time just going with his own Malzahar, and they grab the Jhin for Keith.
I really love the combo of Malzahar Jhin lane because there's a ridiculous amount of kill pressure. Malzahar's pattern he's going to go for is the E and W onto you to get the crabs to start spawning, and Jhin's a root. The snare is just so dangerous because the crabs will start spawning and you have a swarm on you. If you get rooted up for a second, it's a huge amount of DPS. So this is a pre-6 lane that has a lot of kill pressure as well. The way the Varus has been, you know, dealing with it quite easily is landing the consecutive arrows for harassment, though, and we'll see if they do go for the Zyra, which can definitely help out with that. Zyra provides a lot of help with the poke. If you have Varus plus Zyra, it's a tremendous amount of lane harassment, and the only thing you really do have to worry about is that kill pattern with the Malzahar starting it off, spawning void links, grabbing the E on you, and Jhin coming through with the root. If you can avoid that, then slowly but surely the Zyra and Varus poke takes its toll. Meanwhile, though, there's your Graves that you're looking for last game, Riv. He's off the bench here, and we'll be bringing more lethality to the game. So right now, I predict there'll be maybe 4 Ghost Blades if Kha'Zix actually decides to go super lethality as well.
Maybe 4? All right, that Zyra you're talking about does get banned out. Echo Fox does not want to be dealing with that. Well, they may be able to even get the MF on their side, but... no deals this game. The TF for Froggen is at the top and mid ban here to hit Looper in mid.
Yeah, it is interesting that they do opt to answer the jungle predict position here and instead of the support position. I do think that you do drop off quite a bit if you get pushed further down the jungle position. And even though you would like to grab the Zyra now, yeah, Karma, not so bad. And Preferred's a pretty similar role, so that may be what they're going for down there on the bottom side. For Aphromoo, more expected, unless they decide to completely flip the switch and try and get Aphromoo actually on one of those playmaking champions, rather than just the supportive speed shield.
Sticks they could go. Lulu for Aphromoo. Corki still up here for Froggen. Could really just get that easily with a Jhin in there.
Now returning to the other supportive speed shield, the Lulu for themselves.
Do it.
Nah. All right, Samara. Let's see here. To pull it all together for Echo Fox, let's see. The Maokai's already off the table. Nautilus as well was targeting the second ban phase, so Looper is going to be dropping down a little bit.
Singed.
Hey, the Insta-Lock is classic Looper singed. Yes.
Not even a thought. That's like the first phase. They're like, Looper, you can pick singed.
Will he play his Samsung White singed into the Darshan shed?
I think he has to, doesn't he?
I hope so. And this is super interesting twist here because this is now going to be so much more split push threat here for Echo Fox.
Yeah.
Especially if Looper can take advantage of this matchup. Whereas CLG, they're looking to have, you know, the Shen teleport into the four-man combo and try and pull off those plays. The Shen just creating havoc, building the three early ring start here for the extra regeneration. And the big part of that as well is that mana is converted into health percentage for his passive, so he also gets tanky off those.
Sounds about right. He's a mad chemist. He figured it out. 30 seconds left on the clock here as the teams discuss what the early game is about, mid game, and if they're even going to let the other team get to late game. And we did have a very scrappy fight last time. It looks like things could slow down a little bit here. We got a bit of a poke composition coming out of Fox, but once the few members of their team do get in, it is going to be messy. Chronologic Gaming again going with that Shen composition, looking for safety and just all-around map control.
Yeah, and they've got Graves, the more farming-oriented jungler, so they're just going to try farm it out a bit until Darshan does hit that level 6 point. The one thing I do see some action sparking around, though, could be Huihi Syndra. This is one of the champions where, you know, last year he had some really big games on Syndra, and there is a lot of burst potential there in the mid lane. Definitely could be targeted either way here. I expect Froggen to take the exhaust on the Corki, as all of his predecessors have done as well, though. Let's try and mitigate that a bit.
All right, can the quick Orange Fox jump over the Counterlock Gaming? We'll find out here in game two of our series. Like a Fox on blue side, CLG coming in on the red. We are going to be on the Rift in just a second, and we'll see if CLG can hold on tight.
Yes, Samsung White singed. Looper knows it. All right, Darshan, let's see how he does in this matchup here, because Shinz is quite good in this one. He was added the extra percentage health damage to the flip, so that helped him out in a lot of the tank matchups. So we're seeing a lot of him there. Is quite good in the split pushing. This corrupted potion gets boosted in his next couple purchases because he gets a bunch of the stacking rings as well. And it's a pretty good early game where Singe was a little bit lackluster before, but very efficient new item pathings. And Darshan actually will start the game out being chased out of the enemy jungle. Did get his ward down, though, in time to try and see where Akkadian will start.
Got that teleport and ghost for Looper, so we can be a menace, get himself running around. See, Snixay did get that Varus away from Keith. He was on Ashe last game, so we'll have to see how this lane goes now that they've switched to Varus. Lulu may feel a little bit more comfortable.
And Lulu can fairly quickly, especially compared to other supports, take out the grabs from Malzahar with the extra picks damage from auto attacks. The slows from Glitterlance also help out a lot in disengaging that kind of kill pattern we talked about from Jhin and Malzahar. So gonna try and keep Snixay safe in case he is not able to dodge all of the snares from Keith. There comes though Gate with the swarm. Getting a decent amount of harass onto Afro.
Bit of vision for CLG there as they obviously have the start for Fox.
Oh, early gank from Smithy.
Smithy's gonna hit in. It's level one, no Valkyrie. This is gonna be a flash or just the exhaust. End of the line's gonna miss. Good directional positioning by Froggen. And McSmithy looks for a very, very early aggression.
Yeah, super early visit here. He did get the exhaust out, so
yes,
rewarded for that pass. Let's see what Akkadian does for it, though, because that put Akkadian one camp ahead of Smithy. And Smithy's going straight buff to buff here, trying to make sure he doesn't get invaded and contested on his blue buff.
Bot lane getting pushed in quite hard. This gives Smithy something to think about, but a little bit of pressure relief for Akkadian. We'll see if he decides to go do something now, and he will go mid.
Yeah, so often though, we'll see if the enemy jungler shows early in mid like that, denied, still gets the Thunderlord's proc. Actually, there from Frog in a decent trade, but so often if you go for a level 2 gank like we saw from Smithy,
right,
especially if the enemy jungler is a Kha'Zix, you know, we'll go in there looking for you to try and find you when he's got the level advantage, but he just goes to answer the mid lane gank here. He doesn't get rewarded with a summoner spell, however.
Ooh. don't know. CLG said, we like that, but it seems a little like too much damage. They didn't go fully on the gate just yet.
Gideon not giving up.
We'll be safe.
Pew, 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 pew.
There you go. Yep.
He keeps it up.
Got you covered.
Does eventually get the flash out. Looper already with the proxy singe. Super annoying. He was able to cut off one of those minion lines, then goes to annoy the enemy jungler. The next minion wave is getting through, but it is a 3v2 here. Froggen's coming in to try and cut him off. Acadian!
The love in the beginning of this game for First Blood is immense, and they finally find it onto Hoogie. Flash goes down. There's a lot of action towards the mid lane right now.
Good awareness from Looper and the Echo Fox trio there. They don't chase Smithy up into the brush either. Another Darshan has rotated down, and Acadian again, another First Blood for himself on this Kha'Zix. Keeping up their ganks towards the mid lane.
He's staying true to what he said coming in. I like aggression. Teleport back up, just laughs himself into more flings. We'll see this again.
And they have a ward here. They have a ward there on
great
the
jump.
Raptor camp as well. They know that Hoogie used his flash earlier, and the ghost is not going to get you out of that one.
Looper. Looper's laughing. I don't know if he's going to be laughing all the way home on this one. He should go down here. Just hanging out in the brush. Oh, he might get a kill! Smithy's already got a kill!
He's still laughing!
He's still laughing!
Classic Singe! I almost got two of them!
Oh, my word.
Oh, man. The minion's trying to help him out there. Go after one of the world champ skins, and he takes one with him.
This is zany. This is getting crazy.
Classic Singe counter kills here. Inhaled too many toxins as they went for him. Yeah, kind of. It's the combination of poison plus minions.
Look at that. He killed the wave, and then they fought him in a full wave.
Yeah.
Ouchies. Ouchies.
The Hotara wave turns on Smithy here. It's cannon plus four ranged, and he barely gets into that brush. They dropped a ward down to try and help him out, but he almost got it. Yeah. He's like, classic Singed play. Real funny.
Oh, man. That's got to make you feel good, though. That obviously kind of lifts up the spirits. You're having fun in the game. Echo Fox coming off a win here. So, looking good. I'm feeling good.
Yeah. It's always a good feeling as a jungler when, you know, you see your top laner get ganked and you're like, oh, no, I'm sorry, man. I can't be there for you. But then he gets the counter kill in a 1v2. And you're like, all right. Not so bad anymore because now I get free time to go counter jungle, try and get some control on the field. And it looks like his first target was the Scuttlecrab, so... Gideon back out here with an extra longsword as well. We'll see if he can go make up for it here for Looper as he's wrapping around for a lane gank. They do expect repeat ganks here. I think he's mostly setting up for counter gank here, but Looper could flip him right over there. Also, they're trying to go to the source of the global. Mm-hmm. The classic here. Shen is going to stand United somewhere else. Oh, no! Even if you have a skin on the champion, still can misclick sometimes.
Things that make you feel better about yourself.
Or was he just like, Cadian, this minion has been looking at me crooked all game long.
I know you want a gank.
Take care of this guy.
I have the gold. There's the tax. 2-1. Looking for Smithy to pull that back into his favor. Let's see if who he was going to go aggressive here and pull him in. But they're just farming at the turret. No troubles there. But there may be some trouble here on the high road.
Ooh, yeah. Face checking into a Kha'Zix. You got to
fly. No.
Almost got him. That.
Oh! My mid laner is here first.
Is that what he said?
So here's what went down there, though. Froggen started roaming away from the mid lane early, so that's why Hoogie put two and two together. I'm just so proud of Hoogie right now. Any sort of mid laner, if they're in your game, keeping up with the enemy mid laner roams. Yeah. He's like, some reason Froggen is leaving my lane right now. I'm going to come walk right behind Smithy.
Yep.
And because he is on the defending side, they have the inside route and they get the kill here. So from all junglers all around the world in Silky, thank you very much, Uhi, for protecting your jungler. And he was rewarded with the money as well. So
let's see if Acadian decides to go back in that side of the jungle. They were getting some good control for Looper in the top side.
Level 6.
Bot side, we haven't seen too much love or action. And now they start sending each other chocolate six, Smithy. Or sorry, stick say. Just saw X's. Almost goes down. He gets the save.
See, if that snare would have hit, that is a kill. All you need to do, spawn all the Voidlings on him and land the snare. But very, very crucial sidestep there. 6A barely able to get out of it. Even though they hit 6 first, Keith now is going to be able to grab that. And he's the one with the ultimate advantage now.
I'm going to check the supports real quick. Oh, they're not even going to wait for the level 6 to come in as well.
Looking at, yeah, just open up here. Smithy, though, was ready for this.
Whoa. Oh, gate. Collateral damage goes down. Smithy saw that 6 coming up. He was like, yeah, I feel like we're going to get ganked here in the bot lane.
Darshan's
already on it. One hit. Very nicely read by Counter Logic Gaming, seeing that Keith has dead on 6. Acadian just came back up. Doesn't want to lose this red buff.
Looper kind of low, too.
Looper, yeah, very low. Wild Growth onto Darshan. They should be able to walk this one out. Maybe Brogan packaging in. Darshan hit. He gets the Gatling on a few, but cupcaking around. It looks like he might be able to pick up Afro. One last shot from the auto. Ah! Summoner heal comes in. Minion steps up front. What a game from the minions, and what a shot from Keith to finally take down Afromu. Again, we are starting to scrap it out early.
And then Frogger just uses his exhaust just to get a trade on their on his Stixxay. And Hui went back to purchase during that. Was not part of the roam at all. It is always dangerous going for these bottom lane, diving past tower when the enemy has package ready. And right now they're making the call already. Hui's like, I'm not coming, guys. You know, you gotta get out on your own. Froggen's coming down the river. They can't get out in time. Looper flips Darshan back into the team and they take him down first. But then here it is, the aha! Baited with the heal, but then Keats get the last laugh. Snipes him right through there.
After all that work, unfortunately goes down, fortunately for Keith. 4-3, 10 minutes in, just short. A kill a minute here. Looper's finding some more stacks as well for himself. Now 3 rings up. He can just stay in lane and keep laughing now. Darshan can't do much but teleport to the other side of the map and help his team.
Meanwhile, focus up on the top side. Froggen's coming up with the roam, but he's been pinged out again. See, Hui's not answering any of these roams. He's doing the one where I call the roam, and I feel like that's good enough. It worked out in the jungle interaction where they had a little skirmish, but Smithy actually...
Oh, nicely done. Ninja Cadian.
Around in vision gets chunked out, and really nice move here from Acadian. He is now definitely in control of the jungle matchup. If we check in on the levels, who he's trying to make his first roam here, but feels like it's kind of he just feels kind of bad about how Froggen was just making a lot of moves before him and wanted to try and make it up.
Yeah.
In the end, bottom lane just backs off, and he's gonna have to scramble back and lose some minions for that.
That action in the mid lane early definitely sent him for a bit of a loop. Not too far behind in CS, but as you said, Froggen definitely getting the majority of the push to leave lane soon.
Froggen again with an early roam here up to the top side. Smithy's on the way, but he's pretty far.
There's that push. We had Huhi at turret. Now these guys are going to be here first, and Huhi, again, might just have to stop halfway. Like Smithy could draw him up further, though. They're looking for a zero out on Looper or Froggen, possibly.
Oh!
Looper going a little too hard here. Didn't expect the damage from Smithy. And we see again where the communication might have a little bit of a mishap.
Or maybe just overestimating his defenses.
That's true.
Smithy's able to fight him off. And Huhi wanted to join that so bad, he used Flash and Ghost to get there. The other members are able to pull off for Echo Fox, though, and they don't have any more casualties.
Great damage and push on the turret down here so far. Nether grabs, Stixxay, you can always get out of that. Nice wild growth. Chain of Corruption just off to the left, the zoning one, right? Oh, Curtain Call comes down. Afromu being a bro. And Darshan as well. They're going to stand in front of those last shots. Nobody should. Oh, my God! Oh, you are Eagle Eye! Come on!
I was about to say, oh, they're scrambling a little bit.
Give me a break.
It almost felt like they wanted to give him a chance, and they're like, haha, yeah, give it a shot, Keith. We'll give you an opening here. But what? Dude, just press S, man. That was
nobody had to move.
No excuses there. They give him an opening, and Keith takes the shot. I have to say, Keith has had some good snipes this game.
Yes.
Even though they are getting punished decently in CS down here.
See it all again.
He's found a couple of kills there with some snipes. 6A, yeah, he does miss his Chain of Corruptions, which would have been setting up Darshan for the taunt. But this one right here, they're killing minions, and they just... Stixxay's going for that one, and Darshan went down, so So much for teamwork and communication, huh?
Everybody stand still. Run around. 13 and a half. Chronologic Gaming. Taking a breather. Gonna pick up some resources here. Fox doing the same thing, putting some core items under their belts. Triforce, Yomu's. You see the boots for who he here. He is sitting on only 700 so gold, so items still to come yet for him. Top lane 101 to 77 is Looper now towards the mid lane.
No summoners on Huhi.
Denies the exit behind the side of the turret. He tries to do what he can, deliver damage to Looper. Bot lane's gonna get hit here. Gate and Keith can get away. Fox is just getting away with murder across the map. Nice lockup by the captive audience, as well as the deadly flourish. And they are able to turn this one around. Huge damage from Froggen. A three hit on the AoE rocket. They are going to lose Looper, but that's been the name of the game. Get some, lose something. But they're gonna get a lot out of this one. And Acadian comes up huge with a double kill to end it.
Complete here for Echo Fox. They kill off the mid lane and then are able to roam down. Froggen and a Looper just terrorizing the map at the moment. Taking CLG in quick fashion here.
Go ahead.
So this was just after their mid laner dive. If you're gonna go for a chase down on the bottom side, your mid laner just died. You know you lost so much map control. Technically, Darshan does have teleport, but they recognize early on that it's a lost cause here, and they've chased too far. So I think they made the call just to not have him join at all and continue pushing up on the top side. But yeah, Echo Fox, good collapse. Even though CLG wanted to make a play on bottom, sometimes you got to abort that play that you've been planning if something pops up like, oh, our mid laner just got dove 2v1 and the Corki still has package. Didn't use the package in the kill on mid lane, so made that rotation very easy for Echo Fox. And they've jumped out to a very big gold lead.
Yeah, we see a lot. Honors went to Acadian last game for player of the game Froggen, and we can see why Honors went to Acadian, because he brings so much power to the early game, and they first picked that Kha'Zix for him, and he produces the results.
Yeah, see there the gold stats dropping down for him. Been doing very nicely for himself. Also feels super good as Kha'Zix if you get to join at the tail end of the fight when everyone's low, and he's like, oh, I'll just hop in, take this kill, I'll flash over there for you to get that kill as well. Yes, I got five. Yep, all me. Meanwhile, Looper has been creating chaos for the team. It's constantly pushing up, invading the jungle, going for dives.
That distraction game, always calling attention of Chronologic Gaming. We see who here, who he now has to go to mid with half health. That means Gate trying to get in to get a kill, but we can see CLG trying to defend. We need to get who he a bit bigger here so he can be that carry. He can zero someone out. Bot lane getting pushed by Keith, so it doesn't look like Echo Fox is going to act on too much just now. They're keeping him safe.
All right, CLG backs against the wall at this point. Just trying to farm.
Ooh, just the tail end of Acadian.
Another roam from Froggen, and Looper going deep.
The Righteous Glory goes on as well. That first item for Looper coming in. Give him the speed to keep the poison on Darshan. And Froggen's able to pick up the kill. Looper just putting these kills on a silver platter for his team now. Mid pressure as well as the second tier in the top side. Gate opens up with the curtain call. Acadian's just like, where are you going to go? Which one?
Oh.
You're only supposed to move when you know where the missile's going to fall. And they don't even know that time. There's just too much chaos from Acadian running them around as well. And they are finding one member after the other. These aren't even big fights. It's Darshan falling, then Xsmithy falling, and it makes it even harder because you're spread that much more.
Yeah, and this game's not even looking very close anymore as Echo Fox are just snowballing out of control.
Yeah.
Previously, though, one of the things we did always caution against with them is that, yeah, they've been getting so many of these early leads. However, the execution finishing out the game after we get past the point where outer turrets are down. In the past, they have stalled out quite a lot and had trouble forcing around Baron. They had trouble using a Vizen advantage to their benefit to keep the objectives coming. This season has been a bit of a different story for them. We'll see if they can close this one out and actually get that extra win, because, you know, puts them very close to 500 here. If they could move to 3-4, this would be quite good news for the resurgence of Echo Fox.
Last game testing there. Base race call, ending game status. They seem to fare quite well in it. No, I don't think CLG will give him the same favor here in this one to go for that chance. Baron's up on the map in just a few minutes. Not much love for Rift Herald lately. A lot of love for the fighting in this game, however. A kill a minute so far into this as Looper returns to top lane. Looks like Acadia can't really get in for the kills. They haven't been able to deep ward too much. So they're staying to themselves now. As we said, Fox not overextending for any of these kills. Control wards on the side of CLG as they clean up their side of the map. We're going to have Dragon Mountain Drake coming up in quite a bit, but it is next.
Yeah, and in the meantime, Fox moving into the red quadrant. There's a bunch of wards from CLG, so CLG put a bunch of defensive wards up already, and they should be aware of these movements from Echo Fox, so don't see any more punishment with the roams from Froggen trying to pick off Darshan, but they still have to give a healthy amount of respect anywhere Echo Fox have even numbers at the moment.
There's three in the middle. Quite a bit of crowd control as well if you were to get stuck up. Great wave clear here. Really playing in favor of Counter Logic Gaming, though. The Lulu Varus is going to be so hard to get by. Able to keep Huhi in that bot lane. What's Fox's next in? I mean, this outer tier of turrets for second is usually the one that's very hard to grab if you put everybody on it.
Yeah, they're trying to 1-3-1 to keep the pressure up, but there's no way that you get damage in the Corki Syndra matchup on that on that turret. I mean, the defensive wards are there. Oh, the Shen ultimate is available here for CLG. They're trying to zone him off the turret here just with this ulti.
Great movement by Keith. Not too many wards on that side, but they keep each other informed of what's going on. He could have gotten zeroed out. And they still stay for a bit of play here. A minion wave is a bit of ways away, but this is the chance now. They reset up their vision up into the jungle. They had lost it quite a bit ago. Three man, nice job.
Strong move down to the bottom side here to prep for this dragon for Echo Fox. They should have no trouble controlling neutral objectives. The place where they stall out is trying to take down these turrets because their siege isn't the best.
Yeah.
Malzahar is a great offensive mage support, but doesn't really provide a lot of escapes for Keith if Keith does get jumped on. So CLG, right now, they're just trying to farm until they see an opening to try and go for a... It will be a risky counter initiation, but that's what they do need to wait for at their turrets. Because if an opportunity presents itself, that's how you start to get back into this game. At the moment, though, Echo Fox going to take their time a bit and stack up these neutral objectives. Double Mountain helps out so much with this team. Not only will it add extra turret damage, like if Corki does get one Trinity auto attack onto the turret, it'll do even more now, a tremendous amount, but also helps out with that Baron sneak and just the threat of setting up around Baron. When CLG don't have vision around there, they have to start worrying because double Mountains means Echo Fox can burn it down very quickly.
Burn it down and also play that poke game if they get there. Really just want to toy with Counter Logic Gaming. Could possibly do that. Levels up on quite a few members across the board as Fox continues to have a lead in this one. 8,000 gold, 21 and a half minutes in now. Not usually the leads we see between Counter Logic Gaming and opposing teams, but this year, both teams have had a bit of a roller coaster here. To the top side as Looper moved his way to bottom. Teleport still up for him, but as well the double global for Darshan. It's been a while since we've seen a fight compared to the early game here, so teams are itching, and this is the factor, is they haven't seen the damage they're providing each other, or giving to each other, I'd say, in quite a bit, so somebody may be caught off guard.
Four control wards in inventory for Echo Fox at the moment. Double sweepers, one of them ready, so they have all the tools to clear out the vision around Baron, and they have the double mountains, so there's an extra threat on them burning it down, but CLG still poking around for that vision, trying to wait their time until they do see their moment, try and take a risk. As of right now, Echo Fox doing their best to cover this red quadrant and clear out all those wards. Missed a couple though, so CLG still have some information to work with.
And see how it's almost the early game for Echo Fox. That outer ring of turrets means they just have a field day with the game. And then, as most teams do, they slow down getting to the second tier. But for this composition, it just seems like they are being too stalled out. Counter Logic Gaming able to just continue to farm up these waves, keep themselves strong. Here, the jockey for position now. We figured that Echo Fox would at some point go for it. Teleport coming in here from Darshan. He'll be
They're
just under.
Smithy is very low on the front line.
There's the poke.
Huhi's out!
Darshan ultimate, yeah, Froggen soloed out Huhi towards that top side. Xmithie's gonna be the next one as Akkadian is over the wall. Darshan in the eyes of Fox here. Aphromoo's already running down the river, cannot give much help. Flung back in against his will. Another double kill for Akkadian.
Yep, I'd say go clean up this free Baron so that you have the extra pushing power, right, and they should be able to take out a large portion of the CLG base. Looks like they're making a split call here to start the push, usher the minions along, and take the Baron at the same time. As long as Looper is the only one getting hit by Baron, and Baron doesn't apply its damage reduction to Akkadian or Keith, then they should be able to finish off very quickly. There it is, and now they've got Baron buff for the extra push.
Ooh. 1, 2, 3, again we see it. Fox in position to take much more after a fight, and they patiently set that one up. It almost seemed like they were waiting too long for Chronologic Gaming to do something or make an error, and they realized they could force a fight.
Only 24 minutes in, Fox is pretty good, good pace here for Echo Fox. Like the Vision Control around Baron, and now they've got the extra Baron buff to work with inside the base already.
Solo. Ooh, what timing for Huhi to have to go to a Baron fight.
Yeah, I mean, you have not very many options.
Right, you have to.
When you're in that situation, but Echo Fox, they starve him out, clear out the vision, and jump right in to get the execution. So looks like they are headed for a very, very good week for themselves. And look like they want to make this the last push.
Looks like they're going to leave Froggen on the top side. Let's see, Looper will actually join the team for this one. Mid lane is ready to be opened up, trying to use these super minions to get themselves maybe a good fight damage on the turret, as they can't approach him really otherwise.
Froggen's got Baron buff as well, so you know this Corki down there, double mountain Baron buff. He could go take out that turret you see topside,
yeah,
but
he's inhibitor.
He made a beeline for the inhibitor. He could cut him off with his package. He's got all the options. He could go wherever he wants. Turns out, does use the package defensively. Also, didn't get too much on the inhibitor.
A little less mobile than LeBlanc, but he's still playing it the same way, just completely assassinating Huhi when he sees him, flying from left to right. Froggen's been having a fantastic game, as well as his jungler, Akkadian. Team coming together now as they approach CLG's base the second time. All five now in the bot lane with the map objective free. 1 minute before we get the Cloud Drake up. I was actually going to say Elder, but we're not even close to that. 26 minutes as they knock on the front door of Chronologic Gaming's base. Mountain Drake should allow them to drop this pretty easily.
Waiting for the minions.
Yep.
Just outside range of the Baroned Up Tower minion. Slowly but surely marks their way in and take off that extra resistance.
The call of the curtain. Nobody wants a program from Chronologic Gaming. They're not watching the show. They just stand back. Chain of Corruption on Looper might be able to finalize a kill, but they would have to use everything, and that would be Fox going in much safer. Darshan to the fountain for safety. Huhi as well, almost taken all of his HP from that big rocket from Froggen. Inhibitor goes down. They're going to move over to mid lane, and top is already set and prepped.
Echo Fox not done here. Looks like they are done here.
Yep.
Goodbye.
Playing it real safe. They didn't really take anybody down there, just hurt Darshan. So correct call to make their way out. Just come back with more power. Do it nice, clean, methodical. They may even stop and get a dragon on the way.
Cloud Drake, I guess. Might as well. I mean, we've got Kha'Zix, who can take it in about 3 seconds. And probably just increasing CS numbers, clearing up the jungle as well. Now they have blue buff. I mean, you can push in mid and top at the exact same time. Baron is still on, and the inhibitor is exposed, so CLG have to respect that push up towards mid. Actually, Darshan, they're trying to chase him down. He should be pretty slippery. They're ghosting for him, though.
Nope, another grass down. Oh, Akkadian over the wall onto Aphromoo. Wild Growth and the Stand United goes onto him. They drop Darshan immediately. Huhi,
oh no,
looking to put some stacks on the Mage Eyes. Just got it a few minutes ago. Huhi's looking for the late game. We'll see if he can get that puppy stacked up.
Yeah, Akkadian down, but it wasn't trade for Darshan, so Echo Fox can just keep up this siege. And they're keeping the pressure on this inhibitor. Remember now, Huhi doesn't have his ultimate, but Jin opens up.
Just outside. Exit stage right. He's good to go. Oh, very close. Actually gets Xmithie to go all in on that collateral damage and flash. That puts him in a bad spot. Not gonna be killed though. Redemption almost came down, but he gets taken down. Nice hit coming in from Keith. And Echo Fox again, in and out.
Chase the sand, do it. Going after Gate instead.
Ooh.
Looper's not laying Froggen? Out poison anymore. He's got full mana, but he's not laying poison down.
Froggen could toy with these guys for quite some time. They want him back though. They need to make a full team push, as well as Countologic Gaming having some base duty to tend to.
Yeah, they got a couple problems they got to clean up here. Flood of minions inside on the Nexus turrets as well as top lane. And that's why it feels so relaxed from Echo Fox right now, because they've got the hard work done. The inhibitors are down. They've cleaned out the map. They're already up one game in the series, so they're feeling extremely confident about closing it out.
Showing that they're a team that loves to fight as well. Gate finding engagements on the Nethergrass from Malzahar. If it's any trouble at a turret, we've been seeing Keith prioritize using the curtain call very nicely. In the early game by Acadian has really actually just made everything they're doing more powerful here. CLG has to respect the lead that Fox has. Three dragons in, a mountain drake is next. We're still about 6 minutes away from that even elder dragon spawn.
I especially like the pressure that Echo Fox put on CLG's jungle. They targeted Smithy early on. You know, Acadian's coming in for invades. Looper is catching waves behind the turret, plus then going to help invade the jungle. And they really snowball off of that jungle pressure. Looper, though, face checking into the Syndra, one of the only champs that can do that. Now they cut him off.
Just kind of making CLG scramble, and really they're just changing lanes. Looper causing trouble. Nice rocket coming in from Froggen. Chain of Corruption's going to wear off quickly. Stixxay trying to live on this one. It could be Huki, though. They both flash out. Neither are going to get hit, but they are watching the inhibitor take hits. One last Nexus turret here, and Echo Fox coming into week four, looking a lot better in their games. A good amount of communication here through these, and a lot of patience has been brought into this squad. One final fight, possibly, as CLG goes for broke. Keith on the outside, Edge of Night is on, so nobody can aggress onto him. Stixxay and the rest of the team just trying to stay at arm's reach so they don't get taken out. Darshan's gonna be the next hit up. Goes down right on the captive audience, and the Nexus is at 50% health. Looper's keeping Huki at bay. 30-50 in on this one. 21-7, Echo Fox. Coming up with a big win over Countologic Gaming.
Congratulations to Echo Fox, a 2-0 victory. Pushing themselves to a match record of 3-4 now and climbing up into the sole possession of that sixth place spot above CLG and breaking that tie. Well, actually now, technically they're currently tied with Immortals until Immortals plays their next game. Definitely looking much better for these guys.
Picks and bans as well. A bit different, throwing CLG for a loop in the beginning. And then Echo Fox coming out strong in game two once again. Getting a composition Looper on the Singed. Playing just kind of calm, cool, collected in the top lane. Acadian going off hand. Had a hand in first blood once again. And we're seeing Echo Fox be able to use those advantages a little bit better here coming into week
four. Yeah, and the most important thing to me is that after Echo Fox, especially in game number two, they got this lead super early on with that first blood and invading the jungle. And they've been able to earn this gold lead, but then they immediately transitioned it like 20, 22 minutes or something like that into complete Baron vision control. They know they have this huge advantage. They force CLG into this situation where they have to check, and they make it look fairly simple for ending that one out. So definitely huge improvements for Echo Fox in the last couple of weeks. Definitely promising.
In the ability to kind of read the early game, we saw that CLG for game two had a ward on that blue buff. They saw where Acadian was, and that's why Xmithie went for a level two red gank mid. Came up short, but CLG still knew we need to get in early on these guys to make something happen. And what did Acadian do right after that? Went ganked mid, went ganked other lanes, and just somehow recouped, got himself right back in.
Froggen's roaming on the Corki.
Yeah.
It feels so good as a jungler when it's that kind of pay it forward ganking where I gank mid for you, and then once your mid laner has the lead, especially if they're corking and, you know, Froggen's picking up the package, but then you gank mid and your mid laner starts to go gank other lanes, it's kind of like you feel like, yeah, that was all me also. You know, jungle, I allowed him to do this by focusing on the mid lane. But Froggen, he just beat Huhi on so many roams with the Corki because he had this lead, and he was taking the Exhaust Summoner for the Yali.
It was a stark difference for Huhi this game for play, as well as how much attention was in that mid lane. That first fight we saw coming back over Raptors, I think three or four flashes were blown. Then Huhi comes back, then somebody else, and I think Looper even joined in on that. So Huhi had a tough start. And then, like you said, Froggen was always a few seconds on the roam, and Huhi would just have to turn back and go to lane. No results there, but Echo Fox does move ahead with that victory. For more on the win, let's send it to Freak, who's waiting stage shy with Echo Fox's mid laner.
Thank you very much. I'm joined by Anivia and Karna right here, Froggen. Congratulations on the 2-0. How are you feeling about that?
Thank you. I feel pretty good.
That's good to hear. So I want to especially talk about bouncing back from last week, because you had a very, we'll say, unlucky loss to Liquid. You had some like games you're probably supposed to win, and sort of tell me how you bounced back from a very rough week to this one where you look much better.
To me, it just feels like I'm back in Alliance, because we had this thing with the, we always win or lose in the odd weeks, right? So it's pretty much back to that point. So I don't know. I just deal with it.
So that means you're definitely beating TSM tomorrow.
Yes.
All right, definitely beating TSM tomorrow. That's great. Something else I want to talk to you about, though. I find your team really compelling in pick ban. You're pulling like EF and Anivia bans a lot of the time. You've got like Singed and Swain in the top lane. You did like the LeBlanc Rengar trade early in this series. What is it that sort of has you play this unusual pick ban style where you're doing things that other teams don't?
We just try to find stuff that we kind of want to work with and champions that we're good at. And that's kind of like unknown too, because it makes it harder for the other team to do pick and ban, and it makes it easier for us to play the game because we're already good at those champions. So I think it's just a bit of a different approach.
And I got to say, I like the approach. It's working for you right now. Of course, 3-4 is an okay start, certainly better than it was last split. And I wanted to ask, projecting forward, where do you, I guess, two-part question, where do you see Echo Fox right now, placing-wise? Like, how good are you? And then by the end of the split, how high are you going to go?
I think we have seen how well we can play when we actually play together and play really well. But we have also seen how bad we can play whenever we don't play together. So right now it's pretty hard to predict. It's mostly just like, does everybody step up in practice? Do we do the same things that we do on stage? Like, how well do we actually practice so we don't just waste our time? If we do that really well, then I think we can be a good, be pretty good coming into playoffs.
All right. If you make it, it seems like you're likely to, sitting right now in a tie for fifth. Froggen, thank you very much. Congratulations on the win. See you against TSM tomorrow. Back to the analyst desk.
Thank you very much, Freak. An absolutely dominant performance here in game two from Echo Fox over CLG. And interestingly enough, they have officially matched their game wins from their 1-17 season already here, first game of week four. That's 8 game wins, but already a better match record, moving to 3-4.
And I mean, it's not just, you know, they have more wins. They actually look a lot better, too, in terms of how their team works. They have clear game plans. They have extremely strong jungle mid synergy, it seems like, and they're able to pull through in a number of games using that, as opposed to last year, just they kind of hung around and waited for teams to mess up around them or something.
And that's the thing. The difference between game one, game two here is game two was so much more dominant, right? We had a 14K gold lead around 27 minutes into the game. Makes it rather difficult to analyze to a certain extent this individual game. But what we can do is we can look at Echo Fox as a squad and the fact that they have such an oppressive early game.
Right. I mean, if you look at the early game leads on your screen right now, they're number one in the league, and I think in all three of those categories. So they're kind of like this high octane race car. Like, they go at their own speed. They're going to try and run you over. And if you don't, you know, stop them,
they might crash every
once in a
while.
They'll go off the rails on their own. They'll bump into a wall. But if they're unchecked, they can run you over.
Exactly. And that's the thing here with CLG, a team that would generally like to play a little bit slower. You can definitely see it. As soon as that gold lead goes over in favor of Echo Fox, they really start to struggle to find the picks and claw back into the game. Aside from maybe, as you mentioned, there was the one death from Acadian invading a little bit too far. He had 8 kills. 8 kills, 1 death. Fine, I'll take that one mistake every game if he's gonna pick up that kind of gold lead from my squad.
Right, and there was another dive around the top side where Looper went a little too far. And those are the kind of mistakes that they seem to make where they just go a little too aggressive, and a good team can punish them, and sometimes they make their own mistakes with positioning and things. But if you don't check this team, they will destroy you. And that's kind of what happened this game, where CLG, they seem to have coordination issues. They're going aggressive in the bot lane when their mid lane's dead, and then they just get roamed on and killed. So CLG is a team that I think matches up really bad against this style, where they seem to struggle if you put a lot of pressure on them.
And Echo Fox just as a result of this, seems to me like one of the scariest teams in the league. If I'm sitting in, and I'll tell you why. Is because if I'm sitting here at top of the table, I'm C9, I'm undefeated, or I'm FlyQuest, right? Look at the one game that FlyQuest has lost. It was to Echo Fox. How did they lose it? Had a poor early game. Echo Fox has strong early games. They can push that advantage. As you mentioned, when pressure's coming at you that quickly, sometimes it doesn't matter how well you or how intelligently you can react. You will just screw up by having to move that quickly. And I think that's where a team like TSM, Phoenix One, C9, FlyQuest could get into trouble just because of how quickly they're forced to move. Not that they wouldn't have a good answer
for it,
but that they're going to have to implement it so quickly, and Echo Fox is changing the pace of the game here in the North American LCS.
I think that's one of the things you can definitely look at as stylistic mismatches a little bit. I think CLG is a team that plays up to the level of their competition because when the game gets slower, they are very competent in terms of rotations and their macro understanding of the game. They look really good against a higher tier team, but when you get into slugfest, they don't keep pace as well. They're not as 100% comfortable on the champions that they want to play.
Right.
This isn't a great meta for them, we've heard them say so. In that sense, it does make your point about Echo Fox being scary, because at any turn against any team they can turn on. The fact that Acadian's such a beast in the early game, it doesn't matter who he's matched up against, he will make plays happen.
Right, that's my point, is that CLG, given enough time, I still have faith that they'll make the right decisions.
He has the faith.
Right? No, I mean, like, we know this roster of five guys. They know how to play the macro game. So if we give them a 50-minute game where they can really set up side lane pushes and rotate to turrets, they will play it out correctly. Echo Fox does not give them that breathing room. And if they don't give TSM the breathing room and they don't give C9 the breathing room, that's the best opportunity for those top-tier teams to take a loss, is what I'm saying. Not saying I would necessarily predict them winning, but it is the way that they would find a loss. Player of the game here goes to a Acadian, and this is the thing. When we talk about early game, he's the one who brought it to this Echo Fox squad.
Right. I mean, the early jungle invade, really nice job flashing onto the Syndra after they already forced the flash out of Huhi. So good kind of repeat gank there. Tries to bully Smithy in his own jungle. Obviously, Huhi able to collapse that time. But the fact that he's constantly looking for plays, constantly looking for leads, is huge for a team that last season, their biggest problem was getting stuff done. And you add Acadian into the mix, he's the perfect fix for them.
Absolutely. Game time from last season compared to game time for this season is probably very absurd when it comes to this Echo Fox squad. Now, we still have another matchup coming up for you today, so don't go anywhere, because TSM go up against Team Envy when we return.